In this video, I look at both the GAN X and the GAN XS to see how these two match up. I want to be clear, both these cubes have unique advantages and disadvantages. If you haven't yet clicked on that subscribe button, be sure to click it now, as well as that bell. In this video, I want to compare the following. One, style, color, and feel. Two, specifications, weight, size. Since I don't have price yet, I can't compare that. Three, corner cutting. Four, turning. Five, mechanisms, GS magnets core. Six, piece structure. For testing purposes, I've completely cleaned out both cubes of any and all lube and added four drops of Martian to each of these cubes. Secondly, I've kept the GES on the GAN X on the yellow GES with the 0.6 setting, which is the strongest, as well as the clear magnets, which are also the strongest. On the GAN XS, I've put the dual adjustment to the highest setting on the fifth click. Additionally, I've switched the magnets to the highest setting, which is in direct contact with the magnets. In the comments, be sure to guess which cube of these I'll pick as being better. Both cubes have identical shades, so there isn't really anything new here to compare. As for the texture though, the GAN X is very glossy, which provides more of a vibrant, shiny look. On the flip side, the GAN XS is more matted, which is more like what we see in the GAN 251. As for grip, I find that I have a slightly overall better grip with the GAN X than I do with the XS. This will honestly come down to preference, but for me, I'm happier with the GAN X regarding grip. Going into the specifications, the GAN X is 81 grams and the GAN XS weighs 68 grams. That's incredible. Both of these cubes are 56 millimeters. Since I can't quite compare price yet, I'll need to leave this blank. Since the GAN XS is lighter and more stable, I'm gonna go ahead and go with the GAN XS. In regards to corner cutting, starting with the GAN XS, its corner cutting is right around that 45 degree mark, which really isn't that impressive. When I initially tested it, I was on a lower setting, which may have contributed to a slightly better cut. Reverse corner cutting is slightly past that first line, but really there's a defined cutoff point. I would say comfortably, for comparison purposes, this is probably gonna be reverse corner cutting at that first line. Now, as for the GAN X, its corner cutting easily past that 50 degree mark, which is slightly better. Reverse corner cutting is also at that first line. To be fair, GAN cubes haven't really blown me away with their strong corner cutting abilities, so nothing really shocking here. So corner cutting, gonna have to go with the GAN X. Heading into some turning, starting with the GAN X, it has a very smoothed out feel, which I really like, and it glides. I find this to be pretty pleasant, especially to my turning style, which is ultimately what I need. Since this is on the highest setting, both tensioning and magnets, I'm testing from that perspective. Proportionally, the magnetic bump doesn't seem to disrupt my turning, but it's certainly there. So overall, I enjoy the feel of this cube, but the stability of the cube is a bit questionable, especially at the stronger settings. But still, I enjoy solving it. So next, I'm gonna go ahead and try the GAN XS. So it's certainly lighter in my hands and much more refreshing and stable. It's not definably smooth as the GAN X, but it's nice. It's sort of crunchy, but I'm getting more of a magnetic snap when I'm solving. Despite the fact that it's not buttery smooth, it's still a comfortable smooth, which is great. The magnetic strength may be a bit too strong, but probably get more joy out of the medium setting, which I did try when I unboxed it. If you haven't seen that video, feel free to click the link up top to watch that unboxing and compare my thoughts from that to this comparison. Now let's compare the mechanisms. Starting with the core, the GAN XS is one solid piece of plastic, which is a lot like the GAN 357 core. I really like the direction they're going with these no screws and nothing to deal with, which is fantastic. In my opinion, less hardware is better. The only thing I would say is that the GS and the dual adjustment system is a bit confusing up front. Without explanation, it's hard to determine what you can manually adjust with the GS portion, as opposed to what you need to use a tool for. As for the GAN X core, its blue plastic core base, as well as the metal rod sticking out. Obviously, this contributes to the overall weight of the cube. On the flip side, there are more GES options with the GAN X, but to change these around, you need to carry around all the hardware. But the real benefit to the GAN X is that you don't need any tools at all to adjust the GES, unlike the GAN XS. As for the corners and the edge pieces, the GAN-X is a two-part piece system with that corner stock and torpedo inserted into the actual edge and corner piece. Additionally, you have caps bracketed into the actual edge piece, which is kind of funky. I have mixed feelings about this, but ultimately I would prefer to have one solid piece. As for the magnets, you have to carry around all that magnetic hardware, which I'll admit is very easy to swap out if you want to change the magnetic feel. But if you're like me, I really like the options I have, but I always seem to draw magnets out of the holder every time I go to pull one out. Now, as for the GAN XS, this is a single piece of black plastic with zero cap brackets. So nothing there to disturb the flow of the actual piece. Additionally, you don't need to carry around any magnetic hardware to change any of these strengths. They also have built-in settings, so there's three settings built into the edge. There's the strong, medium, and weak. I'll admit, this was first seen in the Goiguam EDM, which who really knows how long this has been tested for. Either way, we saw it with the Moyu Cube first. All I know is that it's three settings, and there is a noticeable difference between high, medium, and low settings. And it's honestly fairly easy to adjust on the fly. So final thoughts. Overall, these are great cubes in their own regard. On one side, you probably have more versatility with the GAN-X, with the magnets and the GES, but the trade-off is that you have to lug around all that hardware. With the GAN XS, you get a lot of that customization without carrying around any tools. So if I had to make a decision about either one of these cubes, I'd have to pick the GAN XS. Overall, this decision came down to being lighter, more stable, with customization options that I didn't need to carry around hardware for. So you get that great custom cube feel and that great custom cube without having to carry around all the custom cube hardware. Don't get me wrong, if you decide to carry around the hardware, the GAN-X is a fantastic cube. It certainly has a more comfortable turning style and it's more buttery smooth than the GAN-XS. All in all, I'd be interested in hearing your thoughts on each of these cubes based on my comparison. If you're new to the channel, be sure to click that subscribe button as well as the bell to be notified of upcoming videos. Be sure you're also using discount code HERO at checkout for any and all SpeedCubeShop.com orders. Don't forget to give this video a like as well as comment any thoughts or questions below. Additionally, I've started a merch site, so don't hesitate to check out the link in the description and consider supporting my channel. Lastly, follow me on Instagram as well as join my Discord. Links in the description. And until next time, happy cubing.